Dear student, in this video, topic name is Design of Tension Member, subject Elementary Structural Design in Steel Portion. So, in this video, we will see the discussion about design of tension member failure, what is design procedure as per the IS 800 code is recommended, and how many steps you have to follow to carry any design of tension member. Before that, we will start the session. What is tension member? So, tension member is also called as a member of tie. You can simply say tie member. When tension member is subjected to axial tension force, then the distribution of stress over any section are uniform, so that the complete net area of member effectively used to maximum permissible of unit stress. Therefore, the tensile member subjected to axial tension is said to be efficient and economy member to resist tension force. So, that is why we design tension member. So, the strength of tension member are some affecting criteria. First one is length of connection, size and spacing of fastener, net area of cross section, type of fabrication, connection of eccentricity and shear leg. We will see detail in this video what is the effect of shear leg. Now, we go for the next topic, mode of failure while calculating the design of tension member. So, mode of failure. So, basically three mode of failure we carried out while designing the tension member. First one is gross section of yielding, net section of yielding and block shear failure. While designing the strength of member, at least three we have calculated to check out the design strength of tension member. First one is strength due to yielding of gross section. Second one is rupture of critical section and third one is block shear failure. Now, start with the first, design strength due to yielding of gross section. So, generally a tension member without bolt can resist load up to ultimate load without failure. But when we provide longitudinal deformation is considerable large, about approximate 10 to 15%, at that time this failure should be done. So, such as large deformation of structure can become using this failure of yielding of gross section is denoted by TDG and it is given in clause number 6.2, page number 32, IS 800. Formula you can see in this video, TDG is equal to Fy into Ag divided by partial safety factor. While Fy is equal to yield stress of material, Ag it means gross area of gross section, and partial safety factor will be calculated as per the table number 5. Next we calculate design strength due to rupture of critical section. It is also given in the same clause of page number 32. The cross sectional area of member after deducting of the bolt hole in refer to the net area. Holes in a member cause stress concentration at a service load. From the theory of elasticity, we know that tensile stress to the hole will be about 2 to 3 times the average stress on the net area. So, we calculate the strength due to rupture of critical section. It means after providing the fastener, the fastener may be, it should be a riveted, or it should be a welded, or it should be a bolting. So, in this code clause, the clause number 6.3.1 is give the design strength of rupture critical section for plate. While you using the connection of two plate, at that time you have to use this equation, and this design of rupture of critical section is denoted by TDN. So, for the plate element, TDN is equal to 0.9 times Fu into An divided by partial safety factor. Here An it means net effective area of member. Fu is ultimate stress of material and partial safety factor for failure at ultimate stress. So as per the table number 5, we should take 1.25. Now how we calculate net effective area? So at the same clause, we give the equation of An. An is equal to B minus N into dH plus summation of Pi square divided by 4gi multiplied by T. Here Ps, it means distance between center to center between two fastener of bolt. B means width of plate. DH, it means diameter of hole, and N means number of bolt in particular our section. So using this equation, we calculate An, means net effective area. After calculating An, we directly calculate TdN. Next, we have C. What is the angle with single leg connecting? Here the two possibility are there. Your short leg should be connected to gusset plate, or longer leg, it should be connected to gusset plate. So we calculate the BS. So you can see this figure in first for the bolting case. BS will be calculated. So W is outstanding leg of angle, and W1, it means distance between outermost leg to the center of fastener. So BS is equal to W plus W1 minus T. So in this way we calculate the BS, shear leg width. So for welding, BS is equal to W. So when we use the connection type of welding, at that time BS will be taken as directly proportional to the outstanding leg width. Next, net section rupture in thread rod. So for that, the equation is same, 0.9 Fu into An divided by partial safety factor. While you using the two single angle, at that time your TdN should be 0.9 times Fu into Anc divided by partial safety factor plus beta into AgO into Fy divided by partial safety factor. This equation is given to you clause number 6.3.3 in IS 800. So this TdN for while you connecting the two angle section and you found the rupture strength, at that time you have to use. So before find out TdN, you have to calculate beta. So again, beta equation is given to you in the same clause, 1.4 minus 0.076 bracket W by T multiplied by Fy by Fu BS by LC. So BS we know, the shear leg effect, W is equal to outstand leg width, ANC net area of connected leg, AGO gross area of outstanding leg. So these four value we can found before we calculate beta. So after the angle is given to you, so first we find out outstanding leg width, then we calculate BS as per the given figure in IS 800. Also we discuss the same figure in previous slide. So at that time we also calculate ANC, net area of connecting leg, and AGO, gross area of connecting leg. The value should be beta. Here you have to mention in the clause, the value should be beta less than 0.7, then your connecting size of leg is okay. Next, for preliminary axis, the rupture strength or net section may be approximate taken. The third equation of TdN approximate. So there are the three equations for TdN to finding out rupture section. First one for the plate section, second one for single angle strut, and third one approximate equation. So what should be the approximate equation is given in same clause, page number 33. TdN is equal to alpha into An into Fu divided by gamma m0. Again, Fu is ultimate stress of material, An net area, alpha you have to take alpha 0.6 for 1 or 2 bolts is given in IS 800, 0.7 for 3 bolt, 0.8 for 4 bolt or mole bolt, or equivalent well length. It means you have to use using the connection by 2 bolt, then your alpha should be 0.6. If you using 3 bolt for connecting, then your alpha should be 0.7. And if you using 4 bolt or more than 4 bolt, then your alpha should be 0.8. While you calculating through welding, at that time your alpha should be 0.8. So these are the second mode of failure and calculating the check for rupture strength or net section. Third one and most important is block shear failure. You can see the figure of block shear failure in gusset plate. While we calculate the two plate in that section, you can nearly see in this figure A, B, C, D, D. Due to force act in a connecting joint, the plates are disconnect through the bolt of hole. At that time, you can see the figure number 4.5. Now, block shear failure in angle of bolt head connection is also seen in 4.6. In this way, our joints of plate should be disconnected to our original section. So, the block shear strength TDB will be calculated as per the clause 6.4, page number 33, IS 800. So, the equation is given for block shear failure. At that time, before you find out block shear failure, four values are important to calculate: AVG, AVN, ATG, and ATN. We'll describe the more value of these four in a next our design step. Now, next is lug angle. What should be the lug angle? So, lug angle is short angle used to connect to gusset plate and outstanding leg for the main member as shown in figure. You can see the figure. One extra angle should be connected in between gusset plate to the main plate. The caudal provision of lug angle is given in clause number 10.12.2 in IS 800. Now, what is the role of lug angle? So, when the tension member is subjected to heavy load and the number of bolt required the length of weld for making connection with other member are large, resulting the uneconomic size of gusset plate we found. In such situation, we reduce the gusset plate size. So, for that, in additional, short angle may be used to reduce the length of joint and shear leg effect such that the angle is called lug angle. So, while in some case, as per the load given to you, our size required length of welding or bolting are much higher. So, as per the requiring length of bolting or welding, we decide the size of gusset plate. So, now at the same time, we reduce the gusset plate, we provide the smaller angle at the joints between gusset plate and main angle is called lug angle. And what should be provided, what is the design criteria of lug angle is given in clause number 12.10.12.2. Now, we choose one example and I will elaborate the design step of design tensile strength calculator. So, here take one example. Determine the tensile strength of plate 120 mm by 8 mm connected to 12 mm thick gusset plate with bolt hole as shown in figure. The yield strength and ultimate strength of steel 250 and 400 MPa. The diameter of bolt used in 60 mm. So, figure is shown in data. Here 6 bolt are used to connecting main plate to gusset plate and our main plate is 120 by 8 mm and gusset plate is 12 mm thick. Here the pitch distance of bolt is given to you 60 mm and edge distance of bolt given in 30 mm. So, what should be the solution? So, the design strength TD of plate is calculated based on following criteria. How we decide the design strength? So, we calculate this following criteria. So, what will be the first criteria? Gross section of yielding, TDG. We see the equation of TDG, Fy into Ag divided by gamma m0. So, Ag, how we calculate area of gross? So, area of plate is given to you, size of plate is given to you, we calculate the area of plate. 120 multiplied by 8, it means 960 mm square. So, after calculating the area of gross, we know the TdG, and TdG will give in kilonewton or newton. So step number one, first gross area of tension member is obtained assuming the section fail by yielding of using equation. Now in case of design problem, the area is not given to you. So how we calculate the area? So at that time the force is given to you. So use the equation of Ag is equal to 1.1 Tdg into Fy. Using this equation we calculate area of gross. Second step, taking into the consideration reduction into the area due to hole and assuming some efficiency of up to 85%, area increase by 15 to 12%. That's why we assume gross area 1.15 multiplied by area of gross required. For welded connecting, gross area is taken as a same requirement, because for welding we doesn't about to provide the holes in main plate. Step number 3, choose trial section according to our steel table and the requirement of gross area. Fourth step, now strength of section is checked as per the IS Codel provision. It means you have to check for design tensile stress as a gross area, check for rupture, for net area and block shear failure. So which are the Codel provision for checking this strength? First one is our design strength due to yielding of gross section is also given in clause number, page number 32, IS 800. Design of strength due to rupture of critical section. So we know that the design of strength due to rupture of critical section, there are the three equations. One is for plate, second one is for bolt, and third one is for approximate equation for TDN. So according to our data given, we have to choose this equation and calculate the shear lag is denoted by BS for bolting and for welding. Our next step, design strength due to block shear. So here block shear is mentioned in clause number 6.4, page number 33 in IS 800. At that time we have to check design strength due to block shear. So two equation is given to you, TdB and TdB. So it means TdB 1 and TdB 2. Smaller of these two value is called TdB, and our TdB should be greater than our tensile force. Hence your block shear failure is okay. Now you can see the figure, block shear failure. So after checking the block shear failure, design strength is less too much in axis of A. So second trial section you have to select it. If your three criteria is not satisfied to our given load, so we can choose another trial section and go forward the repeat step 1, 2, 5. And last step, slenderness ratio. So slenderness ratio is also checked. It should be less than 350 for tension member. So these are the 6 steps to calculating the design tensile force. And keep that mind, what should be the design tensile failure mode and how we calculate as per the design criteria. Thank you, friends.